just some spinning reels. And we needed some spinning reels for that lightweight casting stuff, like casting little stuff like Ned rigs and just your weightless stuff. So yeah, we decided to get these since we already have two bait casters. Each have two bait casters, and so Ty just got him a combo, and I went with two different companies. I went with the Lews American Hero spinning reel, and then the Ducket, what's this called? Green Ghost. Ducket Green Ghost spinning reel. It's a 6'9" action's medium. Really liking it, and then some baseball games, and we went to Academy Sports, and we really wanted to go there. And I seen this, and I'm like, dang, that looks amazing. And I looked at the price tag, $70, and I'm like, oh, I gotta get this. This is, and then I felt how smooth it was. I really like this sub, and this is a nice lose. It's a Lews Laser TXS. I really like it, and it's my favorite color, so I had to pick it up. But, and it's super smooth, and I like Lews' grip handles. They're really, really sweet, and so I know how to get this one, and it just casts. I really like the rod too. This is a great combo. Really great rod. And then paired up with some 10-pound Berkeley braid, and I'm really liking this braid. First time ever using braid. I really like the braid. It's really sensitive, and it's just sweet, and the rod is too. But it's just really sensitive. I really like it. On spinning reels, they tend to get a bunch of line twists, and so you just got to try them on the tie and knots. They get a bunch of that stuff. And with braid, you hardly ever get a knot. And so braid's really nice. It's sensitive. So braid's just really, really nice. If you go with a, you used to throw it on mono, that is really bad. That will get a bunch of line twists. And then, especially if you throw it with fluorocarbon, that's really good too. So braid's amazing with a spinning reel. Just don't get no knots. Don't waste time trying to cut out a knot. And so that's what I do with braid. Look at my bait dead.